This podcast is about video for your haunted attraction. Now, for advertising, video, photos are great things. This world is very visual, and you want to kind of keep it short and simple, but you want it to be enticing and something that they're going to want to look at, something that will grab their attention, have a hook. So when you're making video, again, kind of with the whole photography earlier, the first podcast I did was about photography, but this one's about video. You always want to have some kind of story, or if you're showing your haunt, you want to have like highlights or different parts of it. Now, a lot of haunted house videos, and I've done research and stuff, are really quick clips, kind of giving you a glimpse of what the haunted house is. You can put words with it, like gory, bloodier, scarier. You can do all that stuff to get your people like wanting to know and wanting to see what is happening, what's coming. And you don't want to give it all away, but yet you want to give a hook, give them something, give them some meat, you know, something that they want to sink their teeth into, something that they want to watch. So for video, you know, you want to really have good lighting. When I do video for my haunt, I usually have a light that's attached to my camera, and I can turn it up or down the intensity, because some scenes I don't want to give that much away, but you still need a little bit of light, and not all the time your haunt's lighting is good for video. So kind of again with photography, lighting is everything. How you light your subject, how you light your scenes, your people, all of that matters. If you have, you know, if you have a video of customers coming through, you want to make sure that it's well lit, that you can get the reactions and their faces, and you can get all that, and that will be lost if it's totally black and no one can see, you know, it's totally dark, no one can see what you're trying to show them. And people love being in videos, so I've noticed doing interviews, sometimes I'll stand outside my haunt and I'll say, hey, can I interview you real fast? And they're like, yeah. So I'll ask them questions like, how'd you like the haunt? What did you dislike? What did you like? What was scary? You know, I ask them these questions so they can start a dialogue and kind of tell us a review of what they thought or what they liked about it. And sometimes I'll ask what they disliked about it because I want to know so I can make changes or, you know, switch things up if it's not working or if it's not scary or if it's not reading well. So I like to do interviews sometimes, you know, after, and then what I'll do is when I make a video, sometimes I'll throw those in along with, you know, like people saying, oh, it's great, and oh, it's wonderful, or oh, it scared me, or this scene scared me, and that person was really scary. And people like to be in videos so that if they know they're interviewed, they might most likely watch your stuff to see if they made it in the video. And again, after you make the video, hand them a business card or a flyer of your YouTube page or wherever you're posting your video so they can go and see it. Because again, people like, everybody is very self-centered nowadays, so you want to use your people, your customers, you know, you kind of want to highlight them too, because they're important. And really, in haunted houses, your customers are everything, just like your actors are everything. You can have cool sets, lighting, and all that, but if you don't have the right actors, you know, the haunt may not work right. If you don't have people going through, your people, you know, your actors are very bored, waiting for people to come through. So that's very important, is the people coming through. So interview them, add them to your clips, add a little interview, you know, talk to the people. Also, then you have video too to remind you of what worked, what didn't work. But when you're making a video of a haunt, you know, you either want a story, you want to tell something. Like when we did our Easter clip, it was an Easter bunny in a graveyard getting ready to come. We've done other little videos of little highlights and stuff of different things we've done. And, you know, the music is also very important. You want something, again, that's going to get attention, that's going to kind of go over your video. You can add sound effects, you can add effects, you can add all kinds of things to make your video special. And you can film it on a phone. Not my favorite thing. Again, I'm not a phone heavy person. I actually like using cameras. I use a Nikon camera, the point and shoot. It does really good video. I use that for all my videos. But you can use a phone. You can use, a camera, whatever you have. Again, making video for your haunt is very important. Make sure that you walk slowly, unless you want that kind of rushed look. But you want to, not try to be shaky. You want good clarity over the video. You want to know what you're going for. If you're going through with your camera or your phone or whatever, tell your actors, hey, when I come through, make sure you act towards the camera or towards your device. You want them to act as if that's a person going through, and you want to get really good video of them reacting with you. Or if you're following customers, you want to see them reacting with the customers and also getting you. Video is, it's not easy, I'll be honest. It's hard. It takes a lot of editing and a lot of practice. You don't get good overnight. But again, lighting, your characters, what are you trying to say? If you're interviewing people, what is the intention of your video? Kind of have a storyline. Know what you're doing ahead of time. You can tell your actors, hey, tonight I'm gonna walk through and I'm gonna get video. I want you guys to be as gory and nasty as possible. Tell your makeup artist, hey, make them look really good, But again, lighting, having the right equipment, making sure that you're not going too fast, you're not going too slow, whether you want to do like a clip, short clip video, or if you want to do a story or a long video. One thing that I want to do is I actually want to interview my actors as people and get to learn about them, because again, your actors are everything, and I want people to learn about the haunt industry inside and out. And one of the best ways is to actually interview your staff, your volunteers, your team. Interview your team, ask them about how they do or what they do, and ask about personal questions about them, like, hey, where'd you grow up? Tell us a little bit about yourself. That's one thing I want to do. I want to do interviews coming up. So there's so many, again, there's so many things you can do, and I'll probably have to do another video sometime, or a podcast on how to do a video, and we can dissect it or go more into it. I love making videos. It's a lot of fun. It's a good way to advertise. It's very visual. You can add text. You can add, like I said, effects. There's so many things you can do. So, yeah, that's pretty much what I have for this one, for a video. If you have questions, comments, concerns, please email either Miss Creation, or you can email Sinister Sin, the people who make our videos, which is me, or you can send a message to the haunt itself, and I will try to answer any questions, comments, concerns. You want to share something, you want to talk, feel free. Again, I'm Sidonie Banks. I'm founder of United Zombies of America, which is our main company, and we have a lot of little companies underneath that. And please just feel free to reach out. We're very friendly. We don't charge people to share information. We're not big, there's not really big secrets and stuff like that. We're not very into that stuff. We're very friendly, and we like sharing and growing and connecting with the haunt community. So thank you. Y'all are wonderful. I love y'all. Be safe out there. See you later.